Good morning, friends. Now we are discussing introduction to engineering mechanics. So what is engineering mechanics? So it is a branch of applied science. So which studies the bodies which are in the state of rest or the bodies in motion. So under the action of external agency. The external agency which makes the body to move is called as force. So engineering mechanics deals with the application of principles of mechanics and different laws. So engineering mechanics will be mainly classified into mechanics of solids and mechanics of fluids. So now we are not dealing with fluid mechanics. So that is out of the scope of study. Then solids mechanics. So it is subclassified as mechanics of rigid bodies and mechanics of deformable bodies. So even we are not studying deformable bodies now. So only rigid bodies. So the the mechanics of rigid bodies will be subclassified into statics and dynamics. So statics deals with the bodies in the state of rest. Dynamics deals with the bodies in the state of motion. So then the basic idealization. So these are the fundamental definitions in the study of engineering mechanics. So particle, what is a particle? Particle is a body of infinitely small volume. So the entire mass of the body is assumed to be concentrated at a point. So particle is a point. So the entire mass of the body is concentrated at a point. Since a particle is a point, so the volume of the body is very negligible and it can be ignored. So then what is rigid body? So it is the one which does not alter its shape or size or the distance between any two points on the body. If you consider the two points A and B, so after the application of the force, so if there is no change in the shape or size of the body or the distance between these two points is not changed under the action of external force, then it is called as rigid body. What is deformable body? So which alters its shape or size, or if you consider the distance between the two points before the application of the load, after the application of the load, so the distance between these two points is not same. So then in such case it is called as deformable body. So what is force? According to Newton's first law, force is defined as an action or the agent which changes or try to change the state of the rest or state of motion of the body in a straight line. That is, assume the body is in the state of rest. After the application of this external agent, there will be change in the position of the body. Or if the body is already moving with a certain speed or certain velocity, after the application of the force, so there will be change in the direction or velocity of the body. So in simple words, you can say that the force is simply a pull or push. So if you take the example of tug of war, so here, so the opposite team is applying 300 Newton force, and this team is also applying the force of 300 Newton force in the opposite direction. So there is a tie in between the two teams. If you take the next picture, one team is applying a force of 400 Newton towards the left side, and the another team is applying a force of 300 Newton to the right side. So the net force acting on the entire system is the difference of these two. So that is 400 minus 300 Newton. So that is 100 Newton. So that means the team on the left side is going to pull the team on the right hand side. So what is the unit of a force? In MKS system, the unit of the force is kg force, and it is noted as kgf. So in SI unit, it is called as Newton and denoted as N. So 1 kg force. So here, you are taking 1 kg force as 9.81 newtons or approximately 10 newtons. So characteristics of a force. As already you know that force is a vector quantity having both magnitude and direction. Apart from these two characteristics, magnitude and direction, another two characteristics have to be included. One is the line of action and the point of application. So when we talk about a force, we need to specify all these four characteristics, that is magnitude, direction, line of action, and point of application. So these four characteristics together will represent a force and distinguishing one force from the other. So magnitude. So if you take this example of a body which is pushed by a force of 10 Newton, so the magnitude of the force will be called as 10 Newton. Where exactly this force is acting? At a point A. So we call the point of application as A. So what is the line of action? So line of action will be either horizontal, vertical, or inclined. In this case, the line of action is horizontal, it is taken as AB. So direction, since it is the horizontal force, we have to specify whether the direction is to the left or to the right. If it is a vertical force, we have to say whether it is upwards or downwards. If it is a inclined force, accordingly, we have to say whether it is going upwards or downwards. So in the next example, we have a ladder leaning against the wall and resting on the floor with some angle of inclination. So the ladder here is AB. So a person who is weighing 750 Newton is standing at point C. So now the characteristics of this force are mentioned like this. So the magnitude is 750 Newton, point of application is C, and the line of action of the force is now vertical. So it is CD we call. So the direction, since the weight of the person is attracted towards the earth because of the gravity, so we say that the direction is vertically downwards. So like this, we need to specify the characteristics of any force. Thank you, friend.